guys, I have a moment. Luca's taking a piano class and Banks is taking a nap, and I haven't done a makeup tutorial in a while, so I thought I would. It's about to be the holiday season. I'm gonna try to show you what my products are, but it's not that big of a deal. Last time I did one of these a few months ago, you guys were like, I wanna know all your products. I'll tell you as I go, but really, if you're anything like me, like you have a ton of products that will work very, they're very versatile and they will like work. So just learning how to like reuse your products in different ways. And I mean, I'm a junkie, so I like to shop and stuff, so I get it. But I'm gonna start by prepping my skin. Right now I'm obsessed with this Glycerine line. Everything is vegan and natural and organic. Here's what it looks like, Glycerine. They have a website, it's really easy. It's like a really nice thick balm. Smells like lavender, it's amazing. It's winter, my skin is super dry. So I'm gonna like really, really, really warm this up in my hands. And pat it in for my skin. Okay, I'm gonna get underneath my neck. And then when you have leftover product, put it on top of your hands, because this is like, I don't know, maybe the second fastest place you age is your hands. They also have another cream. It's like this. It's called the Rejuvenation Cream. It's anti-aging with cucumber and peptides. It smells like cucumber if you like cucumber. I love it. I just like want my skin to be super moisturized and juicy. Oh, there goes my earring. I'm just gonna take these out. Really exciting, Beauty Blender sent me a new sponge. A couple new sponges, actually. Thank you, Beauty Blender. I love a freshie. I'm sure all you other moms out there feel me. This is what my sponge looks like most of the time. It's pretty disgusting, and that's maybe why I have some acne. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of a sun shield on. I haven't tried this one yet, but it says that it's a broad spectrum 38 dry oil primer. And I'm going to use Nude Sticks foundation. I love this. I don't know if it's out yet. I should know since I work with the company. Let's see how it goes. I don't know where my other color is. I have two of them I like to blend together. This is nice because it has lavender oil in it, and it's a little heavier than their other foundation. It's called Tinted Cover, and I really like it. The other thing I've been using right now that I love and I randomly found at Blue Mercury is this Moon and Aster Real Glow Skin Tint. It's really, really nice. It's sheer, but it has coverage and you can build it. And then the only thing is I got kind of bummed out right when I first bought it. I pumped it, because it's like a pump, and like a bunch of liquid came out. So it has like, what does it have in it that makes it do that? Some kind of like acid, hyaluronic acid. So you have to like shake it, or else it separates in there. I'm just warning you, this might take me a little longer. I just chopped my hair. So whenever you change your hair color or change your hairstyle, you feel like it's harder to figure out your face again. I'm going to use a little bit of foundation, bronzer. I've used this forever. It's Chanel Soleil Tan. It's like very beautiful and sheer. And you can put it all over your face in just little circles. I kind of apply pressure because I want to really meld my foundation and my cream bronzer together. But I'm kind of going on the points that I want to be softened. So like, I feel like I have a larger forehead. I always get up, you know, I'm giving myself a little contour right here. Thank you. doing a quick job. We're going to a Christmas party. So I'm going to be a little festive, and I'm going to use some things from my Daydreamer collection with nude sticks. This is a Shantikai all over. It's just like a light brown. I'm just going to give my lid a base with it. Any nice soft brown will do. I tend to pick ones that have more gray tones in them, so I can put whatever color I want on top and it's not like, it doesn't have to be like a brown story. Okay, I'm going like in my crease and a little bit above. If you have a heavy brow bone, like I kind of feel like I do, you want to create that crease a little for yourself, okay? I'm just gonna put a little something on my lips so I can build from there. This is Body Language, and it's a cheek and eye and lip. Everyone asks me, oh my God, what do you have on your lips? It's Body Language. It's the color, the chubby stick that I created for nude sticks. It's an amazing color. I feel like it looks good on everyone. I might change my lip color too, but I feel like I can do my makeup in a more balanced way if I have a little something on my lip, okay? I'm gonna use Prism, which is a eye stick. What do they call these again? Magnetic Luminous Eye Color. I love this color, it's so pretty. I just want my eyelids to have that nice glisten, okay? Which you can see it does. It has blue, purple, pink tones. And I'm going to take their Hey Honey stick. This is a highlighter. I'm going to highlight all over. I'm gonna take a little from the middle and pop it in the center of my eye. Okay. Drag it down. I'm almost done. This seems really scary, but someone told me this trick once on set to give your lashes a pinch, make sure you're not pinching your skin, and then like lift the curling iron, the curler up like this. And lift your, like lift. And it really gives your lashes a curl, which opens your eye up. So you definitely always wanna curl your lashes before you put on mascara. Anyone wants to tell me what they're using, if they're liking it, please do. I had eyelash extensions on for a long time, and I actually wasn't too upset with the way they left my lashes this time, but I'm still not thrilled with mascaras. So I'm not gonna tell you what I'm using right now because I don't wanna talk smack. Talk with Luca this morning. We've been taking piano lessons for about a year now. He can barely like play me anything. And I'm sure all of you guys go through this with your moms. I'm like paying $60 for piano lessons. And I feel like he just doesn't care about it, which I think I remember not caring about it either, but now I'm an adult and I'm so bummed. I don't know how to play an instrument. And I just don't have time to learn now. So he got his butt kicked a little bit today. Just focus and care. Like, just care about it, dude. $60 a lesson. It ain't cheap. I kind of poked myself in the eye. I found this in my drawer. It's very old. I hope it's not expired. I don't know if this stuff actually does. Let's say it does. It's a glitter from Chanel, like a powder, and it's really fancy. I'm gonna try it today. It smells really good. Then I'm going to, I look a little tired. I don't normally like to do this, but I'm gonna put a little concealer underneath my eyes. I just feel like it gets creepy under here. You know, if you have too much product and then you're constantly like powdering the underneath part of your eye. I understand it for shooting and pictures, but in real life, I feel like the product collects and then gets in like the little creases, and it just makes me feel older, more tired. But it was a little dark, so there we go. Plus, I have a zit. Try to cover that. I'm gonna do my brows, and I'm gonna be close to being finished. Let's see. I had a few people text me after my first makeup tutorial that I did, and they were like, "How do you do this brow? I don't understand." So easy. This product is called Wonder Brow. I get it on Amazon. It seems really weird, but I love it, and it just makes it easier. I love to have a big brow. This is all the brow I have. So I paint it on. I get the desired like thickness that I want, and it's just fast. So I try to get it even. And I kind of use it like nail polish, so when you pull it out, there is a lot of product on it, and you just kind of swab it off. Meant to be cousins, not like identical twins, or sisters, I forget what the saying is. I think it's, they're supposed to be sisters, not twins. It's hard to get your brows perfect, and it looks a little weird when they are, so I don't mind them not being identical. I hate when I see brows that are like perfectly drawn on and don't look like hair anymore. So I'm giving little brush strokes. Even though this is kind of thick and goopy, I'm gonna go through it with a comb. See, there's a lot of product there. I finally bought my own. Actually, Matt bought them for me one night on Amazon. Package of spools. I was using the same ones over and over again from when I would get my eyelash extensions, and they were so dirty. It's time to invest in my own package of spools, you know? Okay, I need to tweeze my eyebrows a little bit right now, but I don't have time. Then I use Glossier's Boy Brow in brown. Brush up. You want them fluffy. And then when you get to the point in the middle, then you can kind of brush down. So up, fluffy brows, and then you can start brushing down. I think I'm good. I'm going to add a Charlotte Tilbury lip liner that I've had forever. It's called Pillow Talk. I'm gonna just give a little definition around my lips. I tried the other day to like overline my lips major. I look ridiculous, can't do it. And I had an idea, something I wanted to do. Oh, I'm gonna shade my nose a little bit. I mean contour. And I have this little palette, Razika, I don't know, contour kit. And it has nice colors in it, all different shades depending on my, you know, if it's summer or winter or whatever. I'm just gonna start from my eyebrow, and I'm gonna drag all the way down my nose to the very tip and brush back into the crease. Forgot what color I used, I think it was that one. I'm gonna do the same over here. Okay, then I just have like accentuated I've made my nose a little narrower, and I'm going to take take a smaller brush like this and push it to make it more narrow. And I'm going to drop a little bit of brown under my eye. I'm gonna blend it a little. I'm not wiping, I'm just pushing to get any weird lines that might have been left under there. And then I'm using one of these shiny white colors. Actually, this one's matte and this one's a little iridescent-y. And going to seal that under eye concealer that I did. And just down the center of my nose, add a highlight. That's it. I bought these things a long time ago. They're stars from MAC. I love them. Oh, here's what I'm looking for. A gloss, just a basic gloss, clear. And I have an eye gloss, but I'm not using that. I'm going to just make this area a little sticky on one side. I'm gonna add a star or two. It's just my finger. Here we go, I got two. I'm gonna do that. I like it like that, there we go. These will probably fall off in a few minutes, or no, actually they tend to last about an hour or two. But it's just fun. And I think I'm done. I'm gonna add, oh, a little bit more of a lip. Here's the one I want, rose. I went a little bit above my, I just don't like this Cupid's bow, so I fill that in a bit, but I don't go outside my lip line because it does look silly on me. And I'm done. Holiday makeup tutorial. You can add an eyeliner if you want a little bit more of an intense eye, but I want to have an open eye today. And I'm done.